strings really has kind of built the foundation of our journey in the music industry. When you're standing on the stage making that announcement and when you see that sea of people who can sing those songs without a cue, without anything, and you notice that power.
Disband on the news was very, very heartbreaking for me.
When we got into the quarantine, the first thing that we all thought was whenever we were going to get out, the first thing we were going to do is attend a Strings concert.
We just both cried and uske baad se hum log ne bas Strings se gaane laga ke hum sunte rahe. So just one more concert, guys.
And they take it over. So that's going to be really, really exciting.
Strings, take it away!
I myself have produced their shows, you know, at a very large scale, and I think I'll speak from my specific experience and significance to the people who work in the industry, professionals like myself, producers, managers, bouncers, technicians, you know, all of us. We've had this incredible opportunity to learn from Strings, especially if you're in the business of building audiences and working with audiences that pay tickets to come to shows.
Strings took a standard, clear, but perhaps slightly unadventurous Pakistani pop sound, and they made it canonical. That is the Pakistani pop sound. If you talk to a lot of Indian audiences that have a sort of image of Pakistani pop, the sort of mirage that they think all Pakistani pop sounds like, it sounds like Strings. And they are so good at taking the sort of lineage that they draw from, Nazi Hassan, Vital Signs, and they sort of tuned it to perfection. And they are really, really good at that. Three major reasons. One, their sound is very palatable. They make easy to listen to music, standard guitar pop. They're the sort of default sound of Pakistani pop music. Two, they've been around so long, they continue showing up. And so they put out a lot of material over a long time. They play a lot of concerts. And so they've attracted a lot of audiences just through grind and through being around for a long time.
What I feel Strings has been really good at is that they've understood what their limitations are, and then they've brought in things to supplement it. So for example, when you go watch, at least when I've seen Strings live, they have another guy who does the guitar solos for them. And your experience in the concert is enhanced because of that. Similarly, bringing in Anwar Maqsood as a lyricist, maybe they felt, didn't feel confident in their old style or whatever, but it really allowed that to become part of Strings' identity. Anwar Maqsood plays such a big role in, you know, the complementing the melodies and mood that Strings music sets up. And he's been really great at, you know, giving them their lyricism both depth without needing to resort to a lot of complexity. There's a bunch of things that happens both Pakistani society and specifically Pakistani music around 2007. That's a time where there's widespread issues with terrorism across the country. There's a big change in the media where everything becomes news oriented. It's a time when concerts, etc., are effectively impossible to hold. And it's a time, 2008, when Coke Studio launches, which is very novel in terms of its distribution, because what is happening is that in the absence of record sales. You had a corporate that was taking over the distribution by putting it across the media. And regardless of the merits or demerits of Coke Studio itself, over the next 13 years, what we saw was that increasingly more and more corporates were releasing music as part of their brand campaigns. And for a variety of reasons, the people who were employed to make this music tended to be the people who were stars in the 2000s and the 90s. And so now you're in a situation in Pakistan where really it's almost impossible, and it's been true for 10 years or so, that it's very impossible for newer acts to be able to establish themselves, to be able to earn anything out of music, because the only sources of earning and revenue and relevance have been monopolized by bands such as Strings. And I feel that at some level, you know, like this isn't something that anyone set out to do and had a nefarious plan. But you do wonder that having been part of this thing for so long, how come these bands never really sought to grapple with the economics of this situation?
Jal phal yeh